basketball time here from the crown jewel of the Tennessee Valley, as tonight the Bulldog people from all over travel here to Normal, Alabama to see A&M take on the SWAC champion, defending SWAC champion, Texas Southern University. Good afternoon, I'm Chauncey Sanders, and I'm being joined alongside by none other than legendary head coach Van Petaway. Coach, the guys are finally back home, and boy, could they not be any happier to be back home, as the road trip did them no favors at all, losing all three. Let's start back from the beginning, Coach. They left January 4th and have been on the road since. They took on Alcorn State. They had a hard-fought game. They lost 69-61. Then they travel, Coach, to Jackson State University, and they lose a tough one again, 72-64. But yet, Coach, they finally make their way back. MLK Day, they fought hard. They lead in the first half, but then are only score 20 points in the second half of that game, and they lose to Alabama State 69-61. Now, Coach, during that run, they were out-rebounded 106-87. How does it feel, Coach, when you go through a losing streak like this and a couple of tough games like they have had so far? How do you get back into that groove?
Well, I think playing at home will have a lot to do with that, Chauncey. And I think they were in all three ball games. What we did, we had to come back from some big leads, and you didn't have enough gas to just climb the mountain, to get over the mountain. You climbed the mountain, but you didn't get over it. So I think playing at home, you know, they're more comfortable here. They shoot better basketball. They got their home crowd behind them, so I expect our kids to be ready to play. And they're playing a very tough Texas Southern team, despite their record. You know, they only have that one conference win. But let me tell you something. What a lot of people don't know is that they have had a lot of injuries. And guess what? Unfortunately for us, he'll be getting two of his players back tonight.
And we'll also be losing the player, Coach, in the player that we desperately need in games like this, in Cameron Tucker.
Well, Cameron, right now, Chauncey, I might have a surprise for you. Cameron is probably going to play tonight.
Wow.
He's probably going to play.
Speaking of Cameron Tucker, right behind us, right on cue.
Right.
How about that?
Right. He's going to play, and I think they're going to try to see if Austin Harvell can play tonight also. So we may have two of the kids that have been out. We've had three out. So two of them may be able to step on the floor and try to help us out tonight.
Awesome. Now we can look forward to head for this heavyweight matchup, Coach. This is no easy team despite the record. They're the reigning SWAC champs, as we mentioned prior. But also, Coach, they're number three team scoring as well in this conference, as this will be a top three matchup in scoring. A&M at one point was number one before they went on the road. Now back, they've fallen to number two. Not bad at all. But, Coach, this will be a heavy-hitting game. What can we expect offensively from both of these ball clubs?
Well, for us, we've got to get out in transition. You know, we play our best basketball when we're getting out in transition, so we don't have to go five on five. And I think that's one of the things that Coach Hughley's going to try tonight. And then on the defensive end, he's going to try to play multiple defenses to try to mix it up, because Texas Southern, hey, they have a very strong team, and they like to shoot the basketball. The three-point line is not their friend. You know, they're last in the conference and shooting from the three-point line. So we've got to make sure that we take away those tools from them and force them. If you want a team to shoot threes, this is the team to shoot threes, because they're dead last in the SWAC when it comes to shooting percentages from the three. So I expect a very good ball game. You got a veteran coach over there on the sidelines in Johnny Jones. Had an opportunity to talk to him before the game, and his big thing was, they got to win the glass. They got to win the battle of the glass in order to even be able to stay close to Alabama A&M.
That's right. And A&M has had their own struggles. As mentioned, the Bulldogs, during that three-game losing streak, were out-rebounded 106-87 during that run, Coach. Unacceptable, but we'll be looking forward to seeing the guys get a handle on that and make their adjustments here at home.
Right. Being at home, you got to play with more confidence. So I expect us to crash the glass and get more rebounds.
Now, Coach, this is a different type of home atmosphere that we have been used to since we have came over here from Elmore Gymnasium to the new event center. Kids have been out on break. The crowd has just been a little iffy, but it's been there. But now, Coach, the students are back on campus. The fans are showing up, and we're seeing a lot more familiar faces around this building. How do you expect the players to come out with the atmosphere like this?
Well, I think they'll feel the energy. That's what you got to do. We got to establish our home court here. And that's what school being in now, that's what we expect for our students to come out, support both of these teams.
That's right. Now, when we come back, we will get, of course, the starting lineups and your action right here on the campus of Alabama A&M here in Normal, Alabama at the Crown Jewel of the Tennessee Valley. Welcome back to Normal, Alabama, as we get both starting lineups here.
And Chauncey, if you notice, Coach Hughley is going with his big lineup. He's got both of the big kids in there, Blaze and EJ. He's going for the size. I guess he wants to find out early if they can beat the front line of Texas Southern.
Starting for the Bulldogs, as Coach mentioned, Big Blaze Akinobe, as well as EJ Williams, with his normal backcourt tandem of Thompson and Hicks, as well as Smith rounding out that front court with Williams and Akinobe.
And then for Texas Southern, they got Barnes, a 6'5 guard. They also got Carl Nicholson, number 12, Mortal, Farouk, and Walker. Texas Southern won that tip, and we're in now. Man-to-man defense.
Nice ball movement here early on by the Tigers. Mid-range is up and is put down by Mortal.
Yeah, with that opening right there, we were in our matchup zone, and we didn't match it up right that time.
Coach, this is no team to sneeze at. We've been mentioning that over and over.
Right.
This team went head-to-head with one of the final four teams, Coach, in Kansas.
Right, right.
And national champion team.
Right. And Texas Southern has come out in the zone. I guess they've been watching a lot of tapes. You know, Arkansas Pine Bluff, they held our offense in check by playing the 2-3 zone because Johnny Jones is known for his man-to-man defense, but he's coming out in this game, coming out in this zone.
The legendary head coach, Johnny Jones. Also, joining Coach Jones will be his assistants and Chiron Chapman, Josh White, Brandon Chambers, excuse me, as well as Shelby Teese.
Wow. They've got two good looks against this zone. We got to put more pressure on the ball, the guy with the ball in his hand. Messiah surveying and try to figure out what's the best way to attack this zone.
Smith over to Akinobe, inside for Williams. He'll fake, takes a tough shot. No good, but he'll be pummeled as he'll be at the line for two.
Good high-low against the zone. Blaze was able to drop it down. Normally, you got an EJ up passing down to Blaze, so that's a good way to switch it up.
And Coach, how about the confidence Akinobe has been showing in the last couple games? We saw him have a great game here, of course, at home, but he was able to translate that on the road as well.
Right.
And now we're seeing it early on here in the first half.
Right, he had a tremendous game against Alabama State, you know, in terms of blocks, rebounds, and the things that he did on the court. So I'm real happy for Blaze. You know, I think all along the big thing with him, he needed to get on the floor.
Williams knocks down the second of the pair. It's been a relatively solid free throw shooter for the maroon and white.
Oh, yes. And Texas Southern is one of the poorest free throw shooting teams in the league, so we got to look for that late.
Pass over. Loose ball is up and stolen by Thompson. Thompson over to Hicks. Look out! Right-hand layup off the glass. It is good.
Good body control. He used his body to shield off the defender. Texas Southern didn't wait, though. They pushed it back on us.
Nichols loses the ball. Over to Thompson. Back to Hicks. Hicks driving over to Smith. He'll take a tough floater. Oh, no good. Rebounded by Blaze. Blaze looking to go to work down low. He's going to be called for a travel. Bulldogs unable to take advantage of that turnover.
Right, but at least we're attacking the offensive glass, and that's what we got to do because we're not one of the better rebounding teams, so that's a good sign.
Still knotted up at four early on here in the first half.
And we're extending our defense now to see if we can pick up the pace.
Pass inside for Farouk. Farouk over to the hands of Carl Nichols as he's not going to count that. The foul will be on the floor. Foul's going to be charged to Smith. That'll be his first.
Right. He and Blaze were there, and Dalen got off of his feet that time and committed the foul. And we're going to stay in the zone on the out of bounds.
Three ball is up by Barnes. Rattles out. Rebounded by Hicks.
Wow, he went up and got that one in the traffic.
Oh, didn't he? Hicks bringing the ball up the floor. He'll dial up a three. No good. Ball is tipped out of bounds. A&M basketball.
Coach Hughley's calling in the out of bounds play.
It's good to see Hicks being aggressive early on here, Coach, as the road trip didn't really do him any favors.
Right.
It looks like teams are starting to figure us out and close in hard on him. That three ball is good by Smith.
Yeah, EJ was able to look over the top of the defense and find his teammate over in the corner.
Nice fake. The drive is up as we call for a blocking foul. Foul's going to be charged to Smith. That'll be his second, Coach.
Wow, that's quick. That was quick. Less than 4 minutes, you got two fouls already. And he's been, you know, he's been struggling late, so he needs to stay on the floor. But Coach is going to be forced to a sub for him right now. And we'll get a little smaller with the substitution.
At the free throw line, it's number 24, John Walker III.
Yeah, he's one of the veterans on the team. This kid has won some championships with them, being a graduate student. He's been there. He's a 60% free throw shooter on the year. He gives them 12 points and 4 rebounds every time out.
Last game, his best game came against UAPB. 19 points, 10 rebounds on 8 of 14 shooting.
Right. I think he has three. He probably has 3 championships on his belt.
Wow. As he was unable to hit the second of the pair. Thompson fakes, takes a tough floater. Shot is no good. Ball is fought for. Nearly came up by Williams. However, Farouk was able to take over. Floater is knocked away by Akinnobe.
Blaze said, not in here, not in here. Not tonight. No layup rule is in effect.
Barnes was looking for that one, looking for a foul there. Nothing called, no whistle. We'll play on. Barnes, catch and shoot from the corner. That three is good.
Yeah, that's the second time they've run that OB. That out of bounds play.
Barnes, look, gets the best percent from the 3-point line on the season. Second is Swag for points per game. We'll keep an eye on him between him and Hicks. Hicks sitting at fourth right now in the conference in scoring.
Right, the road trip was unkind to him. Good pass.
Three ball, no good by Powell, who just checked in for Smith. Farouk looking to get that pass inside, broken up by Powell. Nice play there defensively.
Right, he's going to give you energy as long as he's on the floor.
Hicks over to Thompson. Now to Williams. He'll find Akinnobe. He put the ball on the ground. He'll swing it back out to Thompson. Thompson gets a screen from Akinnobe. Looking, nothing there. Over to Hicks. Hicks looking to probe. Tough shot, no good. Over Farouk.
Right, I think he got a hand on that one.
Pass now over to Walker to third. Tough shot over 2 Bulldog defenders. No good. Ball was rebounded. No good by Carl Nichols on the second attempt. Excuse me, Nicholas.
Right. He's got to look inside.
Thompson finds Akinnobe. He'll take a mid-range. No good. Rebounded by Williams. Through the contact. No.
Right, we got to have
Carl Nicholas. Floater is up, and the oop is completed over to Walker the third. It's been a tough run here so far, Coach, from the Bulldogs as they had an early 3-point lead, and now the tide has turned back in the Texas Southern favor.
Right, Texas Southern, they're controlling the glass right now. That's what it is. They're doing a good job on the offensive glass and limited us to 1 shot.
Thompson tries a floater. No good. Rebounded by Mortal. He'll push the break. Out over to Farouk. He'll try for 3. That
wow.
One is good.
They didn't shoot that one like they're not used to shooting, making 3s.
We'll have a timeout here on the floor. 14:01 remaining here in the first half in Normal as the Tigers have jumped out to a 13-7 lead. Welcome back to normal as the Bulldogs trail 13-7. Quick substitution. Great to see back on the floor. It's number three, Cameron Tucker.
Right. They miss his leadership, so I'm glad to see Cameron back on the floor. You know, a lot of times it's not how many points you score, it's some of the intangibles.
Tucker driving, kicking over to Brewer, who just also checked in. A couple of new faces on the floor for the Bulldogs. Ball knocked out of bounds. 4 seconds remaining on the clock. No, they're going to call that a turnover.
Right.
Texas Southern basketball.
And also, I think Downey came in. Coach made a major substitutions on that because Downey is now on the floor also.
Downey, hounding mortal. Nothing like having those new bodies on the floor, Coach.
Right, right. We got to keep fresh bodies because we've been playing from behind in a lot of these games.
Farouk dancing, nearly loses the ball. He'll swing it over to Barnes. Barnes will fake. He's weaving inside as we'll have a foul on the floor. Foul's going to be charged to Brewer. It'll be his first.
Right, and that'll be our fourth. I think that's our fourth team foul.
Beat, Coach. It'll be our third.
Okay.
Nice ball movement here by the Tigers. Farouk over to Carl Nicholas. He'll find his teammate inside.
Walker.
For two.
Yeah, we got Walker inside. Nice drop off.
Powell hands the ball off to Tucker. Brewer will tee up a three. That one rolls around, no good. Into the hands of Mortal. Mortal will push the ball. His shot is above Brewer and is good.
Right, we got to stop the ball out top. He penetrated too deep in transition.
Downey, he'll fake. He'll kick over to Powell. Powell kicks it out to Hicks. Hicks back to Powell. Powell will tee up a three. That one is high arcing, no good, off the back of the iron.
Right, now if you notice, Coach Jones told him to back off when Powell got that ball. So they have scouted, did a good job on their scout report.
Walker kicks the ball over to Mortal. His three is good. As the Tigers have pushed this lead to 13, 20-7 here early on in the first half.
Right, and they're doing it with the three ball. And that has not been their forte. They're 3 out of 4 from the arc.
Tucker over to Downey. We'll have a foul on the floor. Foul's going to be charged to Davon Barnes. Yes, we'll have a timeout here on the floor. 11:39 remaining in the first half. The Bulldogs have work to do as they trail 20-7. Welcome back to Normal, Alabama. As the Bulldogs trail by 13, 20-7. Crowd is here having a good time. Had some friends join us here on the live stream as none other than Dr. Paul Bryant, the new athletic director, made his appearance for the first time and had a great chat with him on all things maroon and white athletics and what to expect going forward. And it was just a good time hearing him on the live stream for the first time, and like he enjoyed himself as well.
Right, he told us a lot of interesting stuff too.
We'll get to that later on, but for now, the Bulldogs miss out on that opportunity as the Texas Southern Tigers look to add on to this 13-point lead. That floater is up, no good by Farouk. Tucker pushing the pace. Peek will try a deep three. That one is no good. Ball is tipped in the air and recovered by Mortal. Mortal bounce passes the ball over to Craig, who just checked in. There'll be a foul on the floor.
Yeah, that was Peek with that foul that time, and we got to get back and stop the ball up top.
Bulldogs have been scoreless for the last 6:14 of this ball game. Coach, going now towards the offensive side of the ball, how can A&M find an easier time at the basket? How can they find something easier here on this?
Right, in transition. You got to get the easy basket to transition or force turnovers so that you don't have to play 5-on-5. That's the easiest way in basketball to get into a rhythm. So they got to turn it up on the defensive end, and then when they do get a rebound, got to get down the floor.
Second of the pair is good. As we mentioned, this is the third best scoring team in the SWAC.
Right, they're going to put points up. That's what Coach Jones has been known for. He's come up with some great teams when he was at LSU and Memphis.
Peek driving baseline. What a move as he's able to get that left-hand layup off the glass and then on the reverse.
Right, that was a great move. Donnie put his head down and went to it, and then Tucker's playing in one-man pressure because they had the turnover, but nobody else was paying attention.
Tucker nearly was able to knock that ball away into the hands of another maroon and white teammate. Farouk looking to find someone on the pick and roll. He's able to find Granger. Henry. He'll dial up a three. Over Peek, no good. Rebounded by Craig as there will be a foul on the floor.
Right, we didn't box out that time, and they were able to get another rebound.
As that foul will be charged to Harvell. We'll have a quick substitution here on the floor for head coach Otis Hughley and the Bulldogs as Hicks will check back into the ballgame.
Yeah, we're awfully small with this lineup now. With two forwards with Austin and Downing.
Henry gets a screen from Carter. Henry dancing, drives left. What a move as he sailed that layup short. Tucker over to Lee. Lee puts the ball on the floor. Tough right hand layup off the glass.
Good pass. Good pass by Tucker. Good catch.
Tucker already making an early impact as we'll have a foul on the floor. Hicks is going to be caught reaching. That'll be his first. Team six. Bulldogs in early foul trouble here, Coach.
Right, right. Well, with 9 minutes to go, the next foul, you put them on the free throw line. You know, on the year, you would say that's not a bad move because they've shot so well, but they also came into this game not shooting well from the three and then it knocking it down.
They have came into this ball game scorching hot on an 8-4 run now. Farouk will fake. Carter now on the wing. Tough shot over Harville. No good. Rebounded by Lee. Here come the Bulldogs pushing the pace. Tucker over to Harbell, looking to make a pass. He's going to be fouled on the floor. Foul's going to be charged to Carter. It'll be his first, team's third. That foul will actually be in the act of shooting. At the line for two is going to be Austin Harbell.
Right.
Coach, you want to do the honors on this one?
No, no, no.
It's early into the ball game.
No, I'm not going to do that.
He's shooting 100% right now on the season. Knocks down the second. You know how to mess with you, Coach.
I know.
I gave you grace during the women's game. Now, you know they went into overtime, and boy, what a thriller that was.
Yep, yep.
As I took a long break on that one, but they were at the free throw line, and you know the first person I thought of had to be none other than you.
Yep, yep.
But second of the pair is no good.
It's just good to see Austin back on the floor.
That's right. Arvell has been out for quite some time during this season. Pass inside, and is good. It looks like the Bulldogs lost a man there.
Yeah, that was a missed assignment that time because we're in our man-to-man defense, and we didn't call the switch.
Thompson over to Hicks. Nice ball movement here by the Bulldogs. Lee.
Oh.
Trying to swing the ball out for Thompson. That ball is stripped away by Henry. His floater rolls around and is out. Ball is recovered by Lee as we'll have a foul going the other way.
Yeah. Yeah, Lee was trying to make a play on that one and it didn't work out for him.
We'll take a timeout break here with 7:58 remaining in the first half. The Bulldogs still fighting hard in this one as they trail 24-12. Welcome back to Normal, Alabama as the Bulldogs trail by 12, 24-12. Coach, we mentioned earlier during our pregame conversation that the Bulldogs need to rebound the ball. We know they've had struggles during the road, but they have to rebound this ball if they want to be able to win, Coach. Right now, they're trailing by 3, 12-9 in the rebound category.
Right. Not only that, we've got to be able to put the ball in the basket. We're only shooting 23% from the floor. And you're playing at home, so you expect us to shoot a little better.
Peak, corner three at the horn. He'll knock it down. Big time three from Peak.
Right, the shot clock was winding down, and he was able to put that one down. We needed that. Now we got to do it on the defensive end.
Peak, a little too much contact there.
Yeah.
On the pass deflection, he'll be charged with a foul.
Yeah, and that's going to put us over the limit.
That'll be his second, team seven. At the line for the Tigers is number 24, John Walker.
And then on the year, Walker's only shooting 6%. And in this game tonight, he's already one out of two from the free throw line.
As mentioned prior, had a great game against UAPB, 19 points, 10 rebounds on 8 of 14 shooting. Also third in the SWAC right behind Blaze Akinobe, the conference leader in blocks per game.
Right, right. Yeah, he's long and lanky, and he gets after people. He's been playing hard for quite a few years.
And that seems like it's Coach Walker's identity and brand, too, Coach, having those long defenders
right
in his front court. Because you look at him, at Walker, and also Carl Nicholas, who's right behind him in blocks per game as well.
Right, right.
You're looking at about 2.5
5 blocks per game when you divide that in between each other, Coach, combined.
Right, right. That's Coach Jones' MO.
Thompson, cross-court pass over to Downey. 5 seconds on the clock. Downey fakes. He'll drive baseline. Looking for Akinobe. Pass too low. Broken up and stolen.
All right, he tried to make a play to Blaze. Shoot.
Stepped out of bounds. A&M basketball.
All right. Messiah had he took the wrong angle to stop that anyway, so he had a clear path to the basket. The game is all about angles, but right now we need to run a set. We need to get a score. We're coming out of our horn set.
Thompson driving, being countered on by longer defenders. Harville able to get the backdoor pass and is able to get the layup for two.
That's a good cut by Austin, a good find by Masao.
Pass now over to Granger. Granger over Akinobe. He's able to get that one to go. A rare sighting.
Yeah, Blaze timing was off on that one.
10-point ball game. Hicks passes out of a shot. Over to Thompson. Now inside to Akinobe. He'll kick the ball out. Over to Harville. Thompson awaiting the screen. Gets a screen from Akinobe. He'll search. Cross-court pass to Harville. He'll tie up a shot. That one's deflected into the hands of Mortal.
Yeah, Walker blocked that jump shot.
Granger drives. Kicks the ball over. His shot is denied by Akinobe. What a pass. What a pass. But the shot was a dollar short. Sent away by Akinobe.
That's what he does best. Blaze does a good job of protecting the paint. Blaze says, not in here, not tonight.
And look at the blocks between shot blockers right on cue. You couldn't have never dialed that one up any better than that one.
Got Tucker in the game now, so we got 3 guards in the game. He took Harville out, so look for us to get something off the penetration.
Tucker gets a screen from Akinobe. Tucker nearly loses the ball, but he's going to be fouled.
Yep, we're not in the 1-1 yet.
Foul's going to be charged for Carl Nicholas. That'll be his first, team 6. Into the ball game for Texas Southern. It's going to be Keelan Farouk checking back in. Thompson, wide open mid-range. No, we're going to have a whistle as
an illegal
we're
going
to have an offensive foul charged to Akinobe. That'll be his first, team's 8.
Yeah, we're picking up full court. We're trying to apply pressure here. Good and steal.
Just like that, we get a steal from Thompson, unable to get the finish.
But the pressure's what? We're picking up the pressure.
Farouk trying to get the ball to the forecourt as he does just that. Walker. Back to Farouk, now back over to Walker, looking for that one-on-one matchup. Tough shot, no good. Offensive foul, what a play by Pete.
Yeah, that was Downing with the slide in there. He took the offensive foul. That's what you want to see on your team. That was a great move. Great team defense.
It was by Downey. Into the ball game for A&M. It's going to be number 0, Jalen Randall. The young wing getting early action here. As the Bulldogs look to try to bite into this 10-point deficit, 27-17. Downey swings the ball back over to Tucker. He'll stop, pop back out to Downey. 3 ball is up, no good. Ball is tipped in the air and recovered by Walker.
Yeah, Downey normally puts that shot down. He likes that shot from the top of the key.
Farouk Farouk left wide open there on the wing. And that pass inside for Carl Nichols is slammed home.
Right. He got Blaze up off the floor, and he dunked that one.
Thompson's three is no good. Farouk looking to throw the ball up for a lob. That one is unable to be recovered by Carl Nichols. As we'll have a timeout on the floor. A&M fighting hard with 3:33 remaining in the first half. They still trail 29-17. Welcome back to Normal, Alabama, as Texas Southern has went on quite a run here in this first half. The Bulldogs have been held scoreless for the last 2.5 minutes, Coach. We need to find something quick, fast, and in a hurry here.
Right, we got to find a way to score. You get in, you penetrate, get fouled, go to the free throw line. We need to see the ball going through the basket, because right now we're just shooting 26% from the floor.
It has been one of those dry spells here for the Bulldogs as the pass goes right between the hands of Akinobe and out of bounds. Bulldogs have been hit one of their last five from three, one of their last eight from the field.
Right. You're 2-for-11 for the game from the three-point line. So that's why we got to make it happen on the defensive end.
Like the pass was stripped away.
They're going to get Masai.
They're going to get Thompson on the foul. That'll be Thompson's first. Team's ninth. At the line is John Walker. We have mentioned him so many times. From Houston, Texas. Homegrown kid.
Right. He's the veteran on this team. He's the guy that he's won more championships than anybody over there. He's been playing since his freshman year.
And his last outing versus Jackson State, 28 points. Along with that 10-14 from the field, he was able to grab down three rebounds.
Right. You know, a lot of people were worried about Texas Southern early, but when I found out how many injuries they had, my thoughts about them changed. I said, oh, that's why they're losing, because they don't have their full team.
Thompson over to Tucker. Now to Downey. Downey will fake. He'll probe inside. Tough right-hand finish off the glass. No good. Here comes Mortal pushing the break. He'll find his teammate in Farouk. Reverse layup. No good. He's able to grab his own rebound as he'll spin out into the hands of Carl Nichols. He'll swing it over. That three ball is up. No good. Recovered by the Bulldogs. Here comes Hicks pushing the floor. Hicks out to Tucker. He'll fake on a corner three. He'll drive. Kicks out to Downey. Three is up. No good.
Wow. We're getting the open shots. We're just not putting them down.
Here Ranger over to Mortal. Walker looking to go to work. Cross court pass over to Farouk. That three is no good. Rebounded by Hicks.
So now we've got to get to the basket. We got to get to the free throw line. The perimeter shot's not working for us.
Tucker inside for Akinobe. Looking to go to work. He'll make a move and he'll butter it home.
Right. Blaze took his time on that set.
A little over a minute remaining here in the first half. Don't touch that dial yet. We'll be joined by a very special guest and a friend of the live stream, Dr. Charles McClellan. Layup was no good, recovered and put back, but there's going to be a whistle, a foul on the shot. Granger will be at the line for two.
Right, once again, you know, we gave up an offensive rebound, and Texas Southern's going to crash the glass.
Kobe Granger shooting a 63% from the free throw line. As we'll have a quick adjustment here by the official. We're going to allow the Bulldogs to come back in.
Right, Granger 63% on the season from the line.
A freshman out of Missouri City, Texas. Checking in for the Bulldogs is number 12, Brandon Powell.
Granger has the same last name as their athletic director.
Granger was named to the district 6A second team as a senior, earned all academic honors, and led the team to the playoffs in his senior season. Also son of SWAC Hall of Famer, and there you go, Coach.
Right.
TSU VP for Intercollegiate Athletics, Dr. Kevin Granger.
Right.
Brother of Kevin Jr., who also played at TSU.
Right, and their daddy was a stud. Now, he could really fill it up.
That Texas Southern rich basketball lineage. So much greatness, whether it was from Coach Walker or seasons prior, as we see head coach Johnny Jones, walk over there trying to hound on the officials.
Right. Johnny wanted the carry because Messiah, that ball seemed like it got stuck on his hip. And so he wanted the carry would have come before the foul.
Yep.
See, you see how he pointed to the official's hip? He was telling the ball hung on his hip.
Thompson will be at the free throw line for the one-on-one opportunity. He knocks down the first. Thompson having a solid campaign so far this season, shooting at 73% from the free throw line. Thompson, Atlanta, Georgia, North Atlanta High School graduate. As he knocks down the second of the pair.
So with 54 seconds to go, what you want to try to do is get you a stop now to get this under double digits. You want some momentum and something positive to talk about going in that locker room.
And Coach Otis Hewley puts down some quicker guys on the floor. We're going to get an offensive foul called. What a play by both guys in maroon and white, Coach.
Right.
Went falling down like bowling ball pins there as they both were trying to fight to get in front of him.
Right.
None other than Mortal.
Now you got the first piece of it. You got to stop. Now you need to score. And you got an opportunity now to go for a 2-for-1, but with him walking the ball up the floor, it won't happen.
Thompson in the 1-4 low. Gets a screen from Brewer. He'll dance now. He'll kick out over to Powell. Powell, baseline pass across over to Downing. Unable to connect, out of bounds.
Right, he killed one of the sideline chairs over there. That one's dead.
Checking back into the ball game is number 24, Eric Lee, and also Blaze Akinobe. No, we'll have an adjustment here. As number 13, Xavier Brewer, will check back into the ball game.
All right, so at 28 seconds left, you don't want them to score.
As we'll have a timeout on the floor by head coach Johnny Jones. As he'll want to talk this one over, Texas Southern leads 32-21.
St. Abe. St. Anne. St. U. St. A. St. A. St. A.
Welcome back to Normal, Alabama, as we get a brief look at the Dog Pound, the student section. New place, new section, same energy, Coach.
Yep, great place to be. They're running the weave, clock is down to 9.
Walker tries the mid-range, no good. Ball nearly tipped, fought for by Downey. Loose ball on the ground, unable to get a shot up at the horn, as that will do it for the first half. The Bulldogs trail going into the break, 32-21. Coach, quick thoughts here going into the halftime break.
Well, we've got to be able to come out and score some easy baskets. We've got to get a feel of the ball going through the basket, so I'm quite sure Coach Hoogley is going to talk about that at the halftime. And then the other thing on the defensive end, we've got to create more havoc, because right now they're in a comfort zone when it comes to their offense. They're shooting 42% from the floor, 43% from the three. So we've got to get them uncomfortable with our defense.
Yep, as that will do it for us here in the first half. Don't touch that dial yet. As I mentioned before, we'll be joined by none other than SWAC Commissioner Dr. Charles McClellan. I'm sure he'll have plenty to talk about and a lot to look forward ahead to, including the men's and women's basketball tournament in Birmingham. But for now, we'll send it over to break as A&M trails 32-21.
with another $25 gift card. Only if you want to know, this is coming from our Huntsville chapter of alumni. Let me get the name right, sorry. I'm calling all the Huntsville. Our
of the Tennessee Valley, as we are joined alongside by none other than a familiar face, a friendly face, here on the live stream here in on campus at Alabama A&M University, and none other than Strike Commissioner Dr. Charles McClellan. Doc, it's good to see you again back on campus. New Event Center, first of all, what are your thoughts on this event center, as we call it, the Crown Jewel of Tennessee Valley?
$65 million and whistles. This is what Swag Basketball is all about. Great job by the administration and a heck of an opportunity for a team to come in and this place is alive.
Right, yes it is.
You know, it's a great basketball.
Right.
Now, Commissioner, you had an opportunity as an athletic director before you became commissioner, you're going to Elmore,
yes,
and that was a home court advantage for us.
No doubt. It was an old man. Coach turned around. The traditions that I've seen that already have been instilled in this arena with the student section.
Right.
And I've been in.
And Dr. I want to congratulate you on the job that you're doing as our commissioner, because the SWAC is now the premier FCS conference in the world, and that's because of the leadership. We really want to thank you for that.
It's cool.
Transition. Since you already spoke on football, I wanted to talk about the football season and what's at hand going towards 11 days now till National Signing Day. It was a successful season, obviously not the result we would like in the Celebration Bowl yet again, but we had a successful season. Could you talk about what you love the most about this season and where you think you guys could improve on going forward?
Well, I think the national exposure is something that I relished this football season. It was extremely competitive.
Right.
Every game went down to the wire. And what better situation would you have that at the last game, at the last minute, determined,
right.
You know, who was going to go? And obviously we had, you know, the Bayou Classic, but that last weekend of football, where we didn't know if it was Texas Southern, we didn't know, because coming in it wasn't Texas Southern.
Correct.
Right.
You know, at all. Alabama A&M said, hey, Texas Southern, you know, we're not going to give it to you. Texas Southern said, hey, we're going to try to take it from Prairie View. Valley beat Prairie View.
Right.
And then it just went. And then Alcorn had an opportunity to go in there. Jackson State beat Alcorn. That's what SWAC football is all about. I think that there's a lot of areas in which we can improve. You know, first and foremost is from a collective, cohesive unit. We got to ensure that we continue to have the same vision and continue to move forward in that vision. From a conference office, we strive to bring in additional revenue. And I said this, I even took some criticisms for some people that didn't believe me, Coach. Mm. We distributed the most money ever in the SWAC last year, and we're going to match that and up it this year. And some other individuals, those that don't think that SWAC is a legitimate, viable conference, question that.
Right.
And I think for us, that cohesiveness that we have to continue to move forward, we're going to be able to bring down all of those obstacles and get everybody to believe and buy into the direction that we're going in. As a 12, cohesive unit group,
right,
there's nothing that we can't accomplish.
And Commissioner, to me, one of my highlights as a basketball coach, being in this league before, is having you as the chair of the basketball committee. That is outstanding.
Yeah, that's
right.
A pretty big deal.
That was
zero chance that I thought that I could get on the basketball committee.
Right.
And I talked to my wife. I was like, you know, there's an opportunity there, but I don't know.
Yep.
And to be elected chair by your peers,
right,
it lets you know that you knocked down some barriers, you knocked down some doors. So they had a lot of options, and
right,
they chose us within the Southwestern Athletic Conference.
Correct.
And it gives legitimacy.
Right.
And, you know, whether it's something that, you know, people take pride in. There's never been a HBCU chair. There's never been a SWAC chair. And I'm just going to try not to mess it up.
Right. And for those of us that are in the know, I know how big of a deal it is.
Yes, sir.
Yep. So congratulations.
I appreciate that.
Now, we also know, going forward, we heard a lot of rumors. You spoke about those people that weren't believing in the process that you have laid out ahead. What did you think about today, earlier on this morning, about the Ed Reed news and the discussion that has been going on about the facilities, not only at HBCUs, but SWAC schools, to be more exact?
Well, I think the situation with Ed Reed is unfortunate. I think it's unfortunate on both sides. I think the one point that I would make in all of that is you should never paint an entire organization with one brush.
Right.
If you came to Alabama A&M and you came into this $65 million facility, you would not have said Alabama A&M doesn't have great facilities.
Right.
If you go to Texas Southern University, you won't say that. Prairie View just spent $100 million on their facilities. And we could go school by school.
That's right.
You know, I think that it's a mistake for, and I'm not talking about Coach Reed, I'm talking about those that were chiming in to saying that SWAC is in. And I'll say this, and this is one of the things that really got under me, and I'll call them out. I was listening to DD in the morning. They're on local in Birmingham, and they said that Ed Reed called out the SWAC, or called out Bethune and called out HBCUs. It's not a call out at all. We know that we're FCS. We know that we've been underfunded. But let's talk about why we were underfunded. Here in the South.
Correct.
Right.
We couldn't go to Alabama or Ole Miss or Mississippi State or Texas A&M without the National Guard all the way up until the late 60s.
Right.
That's right.
We were not funded at all. So it's somewhat unfair to say, well, you don't have the same facilities as these Power Fives when the system was set up for us not to have a facility.
Right.
You know, we were created because we couldn't read and write and we were newly freed slaves. We were never properly funded.
Right.
So it's not fair to compare us. If it was not for the SWAC, there would not be African-American doctors. There would not be African-American lawyers. We paved and created that way.
Right.
And when you look at the large percentage of African-American lawyers, doctors, they came from HBCUs, and you can't take that away from them.
Right. And we want to thank you for your time, Commissioner. This has been awesome. We got to get you back.
Absolutely.
So that we can give you this platform.
And you know, we want to get your – now, last season, I told you, no spoilers. We ain't gonna, you know, we're not going to put you on the spot there. But we do want to know, since last year you were right on the money about the tournament, that anything could happen. Upsets came and happened. We saw it several times during that tournament. What are your expectations going forward this season for the tournament?
This has been one of the most competitive basketball seasons, and we have some really good teams.
Oh, yeah.
You know, we won three games in the Pac-12 Challenge.
That's right.
Southern went out and beat Cal and Cal. Major Division I upsets. This is probably the most competitive, and it's going to be a toss-up. As you can see, the number one teams that were coming in from preseason are not number one.
Right.
Southern is number one now, but I guarantee you, going to come down to the last game of the last season, and the tournament is going to come down to whoever you can flip a coin.
Right.
Dr. Charles McClellan, we appreciate you for joining us.
Coach,
looking forward to
seeing
you in Utah when Grambling and Southern take their classic over to Utah for All-Star Weekend, and we'll see you there.
I'll be there.
Yep.
Absolutely. How about that, Dr. Charles McClellan, SWAC Commissioner.
That has done an outstanding job. Outstanding job.
Joining us here at the half as Bulldogs trail 32-21. One of their lowest scoring halves all season long.
Right. This is right up there with the 20 points that they scored in the second half against Alabama State. So when you put the two halves together, we're in a mini slump when it comes on the offensive end. But you can get out of that slump by turning up the defensive pressure. And at halftime, Texas Southern shot 43%, 42% from the floor, and we only shot 26%. So we got to improve on that.
Hicks gets a screen from Akinobe. He'll tee up a three.
And that'll get us started.
Knock it down. Big three.
That will get us started. Garrett Hicks and Smith, they've got to be the cornerstones. They've got to get this thing started.
Hicks looking to warm up and use some of that home cooking here back in Normal. The road wasn't good to him. 5 points several times, Coach. Two times out of the last three games on the road during that road trip, he was under 10 points.
Right.
As Downey's able to recover the block, he's able to put that one up and off the glass. As don't look now, the Bulldogs have cut the lead now to six.
Right, right. We came out the gate and we've scored the first few baskets and we've held them in check. We need another stop and another opportunity to get down the floor.
Corner three is up and no good. Everything but the rim on that shot from Mortal.
Yeah, we got to score out of transition.
Hicks has the ball knocked out. Layup is good by Barnes off the Euro step. Thompson over to Downey. Downey will fake. He'll drive over to longer. Walker, no good.
Right, that was a good drive. He just couldn't finish.
Pass is broken up and stolen by Smith.
Right, now we got to attack.
Thompson on the break. Woo, what a handle there as he gets the layup to go off the glass and in.
Right, and see, that's what we got to do. We got to score out of transition so that we don't have to always play 5-on-5. Get you some easy baskets.
Coach, right there on that play looked awfully familiar to a certain guard that was just in this building earlier, head coach Kenny Anderson.
Oh, yes, oh, yes. Getting to the basket.
What a move there by Thompson. Shot is up and good off the spin by Carl Nicholas.
Yeah, Downey thought he was going to get Blaze to come over and block. He was looking for some help on that.
Bulldogs putting together a 9-2 run to start the second half. Pass nearly broken up, recovered by Thompson. He'll weave through. He's looking, in trouble, finds Hicks. 10 seconds on the shot clock now for Hicks. Pass over to Akinobe on the free throw line. Puts the ball on the floor. Tough running hook as he gets that one to go.
Yeah. Blaze took his time. He took his time and he positioned himself in order to make that jump hook.
Nice ball movement here by Texas Southern. Mid-range shot is up, no good, too hard by Walker. Hicks brings the ball up the floor over to Downey. He'll fake, he'll drive, Euro step off to Akinobe. He'll put the ball on the floor. He'll make the same move again. That one,
yep,
this time,
came up
no
a little
good.
Short. A little short on that one.
Farouk pushing the break. Left-hand scoop layup, no good. Good shot is denied on the putback by Akinobe. Loose ball into the hands of Hicks. Hicks pushing the break. What body control, layup is no good, but how about that body control there to be able to get past the defender?
Right, he did a great job. Came up short on the finish.
Barnes, baseline pass over to Walker, corner three, no good. Rebounded by Smith.
Yeah, Coach Hughes held his hand up. He wanted him to slow it down. He's got a set in mind.
Just joining us, Chauncey Sanders here alongside none other than legendary head coach Van Petaway. Had a great halftime discussion with SWAC Commissioner Charles McClellan as we're going to have a foul on the floor.
Right. Now, Texas Southern didn't get in the 1-1 until late in that first half, so that's a good sign that we're getting a foul early.
Foul's going to be charged to Carl Nicholas. It'll be his second, team's first. We got a timeout on the floor early on here. In the second half, the Bulldogs are fighting back in this one as they trail by 6, 36-30. Welcome back to Normal, Alabama. As the Bulldogs are looking for some F-R-E-E baskets under the rim as they had a difficult time there early on in the first half. But things are looking to take a turn here in the second half, Coach.
Right, we're looking better because you're shooting 50% from the floor right now. You're four out of eight from the floor, whereas in the first half, you couldn't find the basket, so that's a good sign.
Downey takes a fake. Nice find over for Williams. Too low. Downey nearly able to recover it. What a save by Smith. Instead of traveling, he jumps right on the back of Downey, who gets up slow. Hoping he'll be okay. Pass is broken up by Walker and yep. into the hands of Texas Southern. Barnes over Downey. He gets the left right hand layup to go.
I think Downey was shaking up on that play. I don't think they see it yet.
Smith over to Williams.
Yeah,
Williams hands the ball off to Thompson. He'll try up a mid-range. Short. Off the front iron. Rebounded by Williams. Pass too much for Hicks, but recovered by Smith. He'll try the mid-range. It's good.
Right. EJ threw that one a little too hard. He was too close to him to make put that much steam on the pass, but we recovered and was able to put that one down.
Still a six-point ball game. Walker over to Barnes, looking for the pick and roll. A little bit too much on the pass, out of bounds. A&M basketball.
Right, that was a good defense that time. We did a good job on that screen and roll.
Checking into the ball game for the maroon and white. It's number three, Cameron Tucker, also Mari Pete.
So with these two players on the floor, this is one of our better offensive teams.
Williams on the block, looking to go to work. We have an offensive foul called on Williams.
Whoa.
It looked like Carl Nicholas went falling onto the floor.
Right, I thought that was a flop.
The entire gym felt like it was a flop because he caught the foul before the last timeout break.
Right, I thought that was a flop. EJ did a good job on that. And these officials better get right now because I know Miss Kirkpatrick might be looking at this game and they're mistreating her son. They better be careful. Miss Kirkpatrick does not play when it comes to EJ.
Splitting the double team. Right hand layup off the glass. No good by Mortal. Here come the Bulldogs pushing the floor. Thompson, he'll try a transition three. No good. Walker nearly loses the ball as he's able to recover it. Farouk in the forecourt. Now over to Carl Nicholas. He'll try a shot towards middle of the floor. No good. Rebounded by Williams.
Right. We got to score out of transition. Tucker's looking. He's probing.
Tucker gets a screen from Williams.
Oh, they got a mismatch. They got a mismatch. Oh.
Able to find Williams. Backdoor pass to Thompson. Broken away. Mortal pushing the break. Tough shot, no good. In traffic, able to come up with the shot as he'll be fouled.
Wow, we missed a golden opportunity then, nine on this end.
Backdoor pass was broken up. Foul's going to be charged to Amari Peak. Correction, it'll be charged to Smith. It'll be his third, team second. At the line for the Tigers is Zytarius Mortal. At the line, shooting 55% from the free throw line. Also averaging 10.5 points for the Tigers. As Texas Southern spreads the scoring out evenly so far this season. And having five players with 10 or more points.
Right, and then there's no exception tonight. When you look at the score, they got balanced scoring, 7, 9, 8.
As the first free throw is good, the Tigers sitting at 5-14 on the season, 1-5 in the SWAC. As they have been injury probe, mentioned that earlier on, Coach, they've been injury riddled all season long.
Yes.
They had a long, hard fought game against Kansas last time out last season in the NCAA tournament. Second free throw is no good.
Right, and with this group now, we've got to try to go inside.
Pete on the wing, finds Hicks. Hicks up top, now over to Powell on the wing.
Oh, he was there. Powell missed him.
Williams has the ball knocked out of his hands. Lob is up and slammed home by Carl Nicholas.
Yep, they ran the break well that time and threw the lob. They gave their bench some energy.
Pass is knocked away again and nearly saved as Carl Nicholas went flying into the scorer's table, out of bounds.
Right, we got to be careful with our passes right now.
We'll have a quick substitution into the ball game. Check again, number 33, Blaze Akinobe. Bulldogs have been scoreless for the last 2 minutes, although they had caught fire early on here in the second half. Tucker, offhand layup off the glass is good.
Right, he drove it to the basket. That's a good play by Tuck.
So we have an offensive foul called. What a play by Tucker as he gets the bench height.
Playing with energy. See, I told you now, he scored a basket, then he gets us another possession on the defensive end. And just like he's tapping his head, you got to be smart. You got to be smart.
Tucker missed the previous three games for the Bulldogs. Right. And you could already feel his energy was missed desperately there on the road, especially in that Alabama State game.
Right. And so his timing is not there because he's not been with his teammates in game action, but he's making an impact tonight.
Peak. Tough shot. Knocked away. Recovered by Akinobe. Hill! Slam it home! What a play by Akinobe.
Right. Blaze is playing big. That's what you got to have. And look at this pressure by Tucker.
Farouk bringing the ball up the floor, being hounded on by Tucker as he swings the ball out.
And see, he needs his teammates. Wow, they missed that one. That was above the shoulders.
Barnes drives baseline. Tough shot over Tucker. No good. Ball is knocked around, out of bounds. Hey, you know, basketball.
That's first and 15 on that one now. They really went after that ball.
As we have a couple of athletes on the floor. We'll take a timeout break here, 11:31 remaining in the second half. A&M trails by 5, 41-36. Welcome back to Normal, Alabama, as we were being drowned out by the pep band, the marching maroon and white, back in full force now after completing the football season and, of course, a couple of battle of bands. Coach, during that timeout break, we saw head coach Johnny Jones letting the officials have it there.
Right, Johnny.
You mentioned that first and 15.
Right, Johnny thought there should have been a flag thrown in that play. He thought that was unsportsmanlike conduct. He thought it was a foul after the play.
As Peek is able to get that layup to go, he cuts the deficit to 3.
And our defensive pressure, and it was started by Tucker, has really picked up.
Barnes desperately looking for someone to swing the ball to. He finds Mortal. Mortal drives, Euro steps, tough shot over Tucker. That one is nothing but net.
Right. See, now you got Hicks running in the wrong lane or too slow in that lane. We needed to get down the floor to try to beat their defense before it got set up.
Peek gets a screen from Akinobe over to Powell. Powell drives, puts the ball on the floor, looking for a teammate. He swings the ball over to Tucker. Inside for Blaze. Blaze turns.
Oh!
And he's going to be called for an offensive foul.
Wow. Wow. I didn't agree with that call. I thought Blaze had made a good move. I thought he did a good reverse pivot.
That'll be his second, team's third.
But more importantly, it's a momentum breaker.
Farouk over to Barnes. Nice ball movement here up top by the Tigers. Tough shot over Akinobe, no good. Rebounded by Blaze.
Right,
Tucker quickly out to Hicks. Hicks in transition, tough layup, no good, but he'll be at the line for two.
Right, that's a good move, good outlet. Anytime you get the guards that can get a rebound and pass it or dribble it out, it starts your break, you get ahead of the defense.
That'll be Farouk's first, team's third. At the line for two, number 10, Gary Hicks. One of the top 4 points per game scoring leaders in the SWAC. Also number one in three-point field goal percentage at 49.5%.
Right, and as a team, we're second in the SWAC in scoring after leading for most of the SWAC season.
Second free throw falls short, 38-43. Arnes on the wing. Matched up against Tucker. Barnes spins, loses the ball. But Powell is going to be at foul. He's going to foul. Foul's going to be charged to Powell. Barnes will be at the line for two.
Right. Now, I thought that was on the floor. I thought he got him on the turn. I thought he made the foul on the turn and not on the shot.
Barnes, 15 points per game on 36%. From the three-point line.
And this is his first time at the free throw line tonight.
Also had a huge game against Samford, 30 points on 10 of 18 shooting.
Right, and he's their best free throw shooter at 7-7 a game, 77%.
The sophomore out of Memphis, Tennessee. Second of the pair is good as we'll get a quick break here. As head coach Johnny Jones wants to talk things over. 9:40 remaining in the ball game. A&M trails 45-38. myself come back to the campus of Alabama A&M here in Normal, Alabama, at the crown jewel of the Tennessee Valley, as A&M trails 45-38. Coach, what's been on your mind lately with this defensive set by the Bulldogs?
Well, we had some good stretches in there where we played great defense, and then I think the momentum shifted, and we've got to turn up the pressure again. I think when we had the offensive foul call, that broke our momentum, because we've been doing a pretty good job on the defensive end. And it started with Tucker. Tucker is leading the way with defensive pressure.
Pass thrown out of bounds into the hands of head coach Otis Hughley, who is furious after that long discussion during the timeout break at how the offense broke down there so early before it could even get started. Carl Nichols, long drive inside.
Right.
That one's good.
Right, he took Blaze out away from the basket and blew by.
That was such a long two stride as we saw his length on full display. Tucker, now up top to Akinobe. Blaze looking for the backdoor pass, nothing there. Quickly over to Thompson. Thompson dances, he'll find Powell. Nice pick by Powell. He'll take a tough floater. That one's off the glass, no. Fight for the ball, loose ball. Thompson's able to recover it. No, as we'll have a jump ball. Possession arrow, Texas Southern.
Right, Powell missed it, but he stayed after it, and he was able to get a jump ball out of that situation.
We'll have a quick substitution for the Maroon and White into the ball game. Big E.J. Williams. Also joining him is going to be Amari Peak, as well as Austin Harville.
Right. And they're trying to look at these matchups now. Defensively. See, right now you got Hicks and Messiah at disadvantages on the defensive end. And they went straight against his man. It's good recognition by Coach Jones over there.
Carl Nicholas was able to get that layup to go off the mismatch. Williams to try mid-range. That one's no good. Ball is tipped out of bounds. Texas Southern basketball.
Right, with this lineup that Texas Southern has on the floor, we got to get them away from the basket. Because when you look at what Messiah has to guard and what Hicks has to guard, that's tough.
Barnes looking to get the pass inside for Nicholas. Back out, now Farouk drives. It's going to be a foul on the floor. It's going to charge to Harville. That'll be his second, team's fifth. We've got a timeout on the floor with 7:58 remaining in the ball game. A&M has lots of ground to cover as they trail 51-38. Welcome back to Normal, Alabama, as A&M trails 51-38. Coach, Texas Southern has went on an 8-0 run during this stretch. before the timeout break. How do you expect the Bulldogs defensively to hold things down over here?
Well, we've got to find the right matchups on the defensive end, because right now our two guards are, you know, there's a decisive mismatch in terms of size on their matchup. So we got to get them away from the basket, and you might have to do that by playing a different type of defense. So we'll see what Coach Hughley has dialed up.
Carl Nicholas bringing the ball over. They'll put the ball on the floor, met by two Bulldog defenders. Wide open three, no good. Rebounded by Carl Nicholas, nearly able to recover it out of bounds.
Right.
A&M basketball, as he goes crashing into the bleachers.
See, it was 41 to 38, and then they went on this 88-0 run. So we got to get back in it by doing the same things. And that was defensive pressure, and we got good shots on the offensive end. And with this group on the floor, your offense can come from multiple places, because we've got several people on the floor that can score the basketball. And they're going to play through EJ.
Williams puts the ball on the floor. Takes a lot of contact on the shot. No good. Pete goes crashing down to the floor. Trying to push the break.
Right. And see, we didn't get back. We didn't get back. Our transition defense was not there. That should never happen.
That layup is good. Harville dancing, trying to put the ball on the floor. That one is pocketed and picked. That layup's no good. Rebounded by Carl Nicholas, as he's going to be fouled on the floor. He's all over the place. Now he's over by us. He was just over on the sideline, crashing into the stands, Coach.
Right, right. They're playing. They don't play like a 1-5 team in the league. Texas Southern, but you got to remember now, these kids have experience. You know, they've been together for a while, and to have those kids who were injured to come back, it's showing. It's showing that they can play together.
Championship DNA being flexed indeed, as Bulldogs will have a couple substitutions here on the floor, as Downey, Smith, and Thompson, and Tucker will check onto the ball game. Pass too much. It'll be a backcourt violation.
Right, that's Tucker with pressure again. Tucker with that pressure.
Tucker making immediate impact since missing all three games during the road trip started January 4th.
Now, I don't understand why the shot clock is starting at 20 when it was their ball. We should have got a full shot clock.
Indeed, Coach, it should have been a full shot clock with the change of possession. Thompson dancing, searching, finds Downey. Downey will fake. 3 seconds left on the shot clock. Shot is sent away and deflected. Ball was loose there for a second. Here come Texas Southern pushing the pace yet again. If that layup is no good, Barnes goes crashing onto the floor. He'll be at the line for two.
Right. And see, with the lineup we have on the floor, we should be able to get back. Our transition defense should be better because we've got mobile people on the floor. Now it's coming down now to your desire. You got to want to be able to get back. You got to be able to do that.
Hey, guys, let's get some noise for freedom. Come on.
First of the pair is good. Checking into the ball game is number 33, Blaze Akinobe.
And see, we want to, as a coach, you play them one game at a time, but you know you got Prairie View coming in here on Monday. You need this win. You need to set a home stand. You got to make sure that people know that when they come into the event center, they're going to be in for a dogfight.
Checking back into the ball game for A&M is number 10, Garrett Hicks. Boy, could they use some of those Garrett Hicks runs right now at this point of time, Coach? Time is of the essence, but a little over 6 minutes still remaining.
Right, right. But see, with the length that they have on the floor, look who they got guarding Garrett. So it's about a four-inch height difference in this. They put length on it to make sure that they get hands up. Good pad. Good.
Thompson over to Downey. Hill fake. Steps in. Takes a mid-range. That one is no good.
All right. They limited us to one shot. And see, Nichols is there enforcing. He's doing that. He's up to 11 rebounds already.
Walker. Puts the ball on the floor against Downey. Tough shot. No good. Ball nearly recovered by Akinobe, unable to corral it. Texas Southern will hold on to it. Farouk gets the floater over Akinobe. Good.
You see, they scoring off of second chance shots.
Thompson, he'll try a deep three. He'll knock it down. Big time three, a much needed three, as the Bulldogs were scoreless there for a second. As we'll take a timeout here, the Bulldogs trail by 14. With a little over 5 minutes remaining in the second half, 55-41.
See, they scoring off of second chance shots.
Thompson, he'll try a deep three. He'll knock it down. Big time. Welcome back to Normal, Alabama. As the officials took the time out to take a look at Thompson's three-pointer. Coach, not much to discuss there.
Yeah, they
got beyond the arc.
They got to be looking at something else because that they got to be looking at either some kind of interaction between the players because that was almost an NBA three.
This run that Texas Southern has went on, which grew from an 8-0 run since we last talked about it to a 14-0 run before the Thompson three.
They're taking advantage of us not getting back on the defensive end. So I think they want to go back to a play where on Texas Southern's shot, because Thompson's shot shouldn't have been a question because it was from NBA range. I think the last shot that Texas Southern took may be one of the things that they want to look at, or they're looking to see if Akinobe, if there was contact, but was it a basketball play? See, look, there was contact above the head, above the shoulders.
But didn't look intentional.
Right. And that's what they got to decide now.
Well, Coach, let's look ahead now.
Basketball play.
5:18 remaining in the ball game. As we knew, that was a basketball play. 5:18 remaining in the ball game. The Bulldogs trail by 14, 55-41. We saw them plenty of times in this building despite how new this event center is, no pun intended there. We saw them make a lot of runs like this.
Well, we need one.
Double digits.
Right, we need a run.
What will be the formula this time for a great Bulldog run to get back within this game?
Well, you got to string together some defensive stops, and then you need some easy baskets. And now they got to go full court. This is the best time to get a turnover. You got to force a turnover. Oh, they're going to get Messiah.
I have a foul early before the inbound.
Yep. He was trying to draw one, and he made one.
As you see Thompson say, I didn't even know that on the foul. There's a little bit of chatter there between Thompson and Barnes.
Right.
At the line for the Tigers is number three, E.J. Henry.
Now, Henry was one of the guards that that helped them to the championship. I remember doing the games for him. Man, he had a tremendous tournament.
Indeed, 22 points versus Arizona State so far this season. But Coach talked about his last season, and when you saw him go up against Texas A&M Corpus Christi in the tournament, he was able to knock down a career-high 10 free throws during that first four contests.
Right, right. He's a tremendous player. He's one of the kids that's been hurt for him. And anytime you get one of your floor generals banged up, it hurts your team. See, they had high hopes coming into this season with him back.
Thompson, tough shot as he danced his way into the lane. He'll be up the line for two.
And Thompson got to be careful. Now the officials are watching him. He's talking smack to Henry. The officials are saying something to him now. Got to be careful in a situation like this. So they're going to be watching Messiah, because you got to remember now, he drew the foul with the ball being out of bounds before, and now he's talking to Henry, and Henry's doing the right thing. He's letting the officials know.
Thompson's going to be looked at by the athletic training staff in maroon and white.
Yeah, that's Jessie. Jessie does a great job. She's been a part of our training. She's been the head trainer for quite a few years now. She does an outstanding job, she and her staff.
Thompson's first free throw is no good. We'll have a couple of substitutions here for A&M checking into the ball game is Garrett Hicks, as well as Brandon Powell.
Right. And if Thompson puts this free throw down, he's coming out.
Bulldogs looking to put some fresh bodies here on the floor. Thompson's second of the free throw off the back iron. This will have an official's timeout.
Into the ball game for Bulldogs, number 24, Eric Lee.
As Thompson will check out, coming into the ball game, is number 24, Eric Lee. Also checking back into the ball game is Blaze Akinobe.
Here we go, everybody.
See, right now, Texas Southern's playing with a lot of confidence. And you got to break that confidence on the defensive end of the floor.
As Hicks is going to be charged with a foul. Coach, it seems like not much physical play is going to be able to be taking place here during this game, as we see both sides of the floor has been called on ticky-tack fouls.
The officials want to take control of the game. They don't want the game to get out of hand, because they see the chip of this between the players.
Substitutions here for A&M as Amari Peace and Daylon Smith will check into the ball game.
And trust me, they know the commissioner's here. The officials know the commissioner's here. That's the guy that signs the checks.
Second of the pair is good. Coach, I wasn't sure there if you were making a swag joke or a Texas Southern joke, because I just wanted to throw it out there. You know, he's a Texas Southern man as well.
Right. Well, he's Texas Southern and Prairie View.
That's
And Jackson State now. Because, you know, his dad, I'm serious, that, he's swack from birth. So he's been in part of the swack. When I was coaching, he was the chairman of the basketball coaches committee. I used to love our spring meetings because that was the athletic director that was assigned to the basketball coaches. And when you get a guy who was a former basketball player, it helps when it comes to ideas and things that the coaches in the SWAC want to implement. So if the SWAC has been dominated by football administrators, football coaches, administrators who've had a football background, so you're finally getting somebody in there who has a basketball background. And not only him, when you look around the SWAC, the league as a whole, look at how many basketball coaches or former players are now athletic directors. Start here at Alabama A&M. Dr. Bryant, basketball. Reggie Theus. Bethune-Cookman, basketball.
I was going to touch on even before Dr. Bryant, Director Hicks.
Right, Hicks. And then when you look at, okay, you look at Texas Southern, Granger, one of the best in the history of SWAC basketball. All right, you go down to Alabama State. From Huntsville.
I know.
Lord have mercy. Jason Cable. Yeah. Jason, you look at Jason, go to Jackson State. You got Ashley Robinson. Basketball.
That's right.
What I'm telling you. I think Mississippi Valley's new athletic director has a background. So
he also came from Jackson State.
Right. So see, it's times have changed. But Dr. McClellan is, as they say, he is SWAC, okay? He is SWAC.
What a perfect time for that moment there as we're out of the break.
Very good.
Farouk is unable to come up with that pass. Quick substitutions here by A&M immediately.
As a coach, you know what you need to do? Put together of Tucker in this game. You put together his package on the defensive end, and you'll see how productive he's been.
Tucker gets the inbound. He finds Smith. Smith thought about a three. Hesitates instead. Puts the ball on the floor. Nice spin. Tough layup. No good. Off the side of the rim and into the hands of Granger.
Right. So the defensive pressure's got to come now.
Big Smith looking there for the trap.
Texas Southern is patient. They're running the clock.
Tough shot off the glass and in by Barnes.
Right.
Looks like Texas Southern has been putting everything right into the chest of Akinobe, the SWAC's leading shot blocker.
Right. They know how to attack a shot blocker. That's what you have to do. You gotta get into his body.
We got a timeout on the floor. 3:57 remaining in the ball game. A&M has a lot of work to do as they trail 59-44. Welcome back to Normal, Alabama, as Bulldogs trail 59-44. Coach, quick thoughts so far coming out of this timeout break.
Well, we're not shooting the basketball well. I think everybody can see that. But the other thing that I think is a key when you look at our leading scores, you got Hicks, Thompson, and Smith. They've only shot the ball 21 times between the three of them. You got to have more shots for your three leading scores. So we got to figure out some kind of way to get them some shots.
And just to show contrast here, the Bulldogs are without anyone in double digits.
Wow.
As Akinobe is going to be called for an offensive foul, as head coach Otis Hughley is just staring in disbelief on that play.
Wow.
As he's showing his hand, saying he's flopping.
Right, right, right. I agree with Coach on that one.
As the offensive foul will be reciprocated right back.
And who
as
drew
Tucker
it?
Went flying onto the floor.
Who drew it? Tucker. That's what I'm telling you. See, and it's easy to do now. Back, you know, when I was coaching, we still had to do everything manually. Now all they got to do is put in his name, and the computers will do it for him. So.
And just like Coach Hughley was stared in disbelief, there's Coach Jones as Hicks tries a long three. That one touches everything but the rim.
Yep, but we've got to try to trap. We got to gamble now because we need the ball.
Shot was denied. Pete goes crashing onto the floor. He's going to be charged with the block and foul.
Right, Blaze got the block, but that's negated now because of the foul.
That'll be Peak's third, team's 10th.
At the line for the tag, two shots is number 5, Jordan Carl Nicholas.
So see, we've gone scoreless since that three-point shot.
As the first of the pair is good. Taking again for the Bulldogs is number 1, Messiah Thompson.
Thinking he's going offense for defense right now.
Line is Carl Nicholas, preseason All-SWAC defensive player of the year and All-SWAC first teamer. Second free throw was no good, but cleaned up by Barnes.
Right. That'll be their 11th offensive rebound.
Smith over to Tucker. He'll fake. He'll put the ball on the floor off of the foot of Farouk and out of bounds. A&M basketball. Over to Thompson. Thompson dancing, looking to make his way inside. Baseline pass to Smith. Tough find, no good. He'll clean it up himself as he gets the putback to go. Timeout A&M as head coach Otis Hughley wants to talk things over with this team for the final 3 minutes. Welcome back to Normal, Alabama, as the Bulldogs are still fighting hard in this one.
Right.
Ball goes off of Farouk. Foot out of bounds, A&M basketball.
Right, so the defense did their job. Now we got to come up with something on the offensive end.
Smith over to Peak. He'll hand the ball off. Tucker looking back door for Peak. unable to find him out of bounds. Texas Southern basketball. Coach, it's just been one of those games today where things just aren't necessarily clicking.
Right, because timing. Now, that was Tucker. Tucker hadn't been on the floor with this team in three games. So, yeah, the timing is off just a little bit.
That'll be A&M's 19th turnover as we have a timeout by Texas Southern, unable to get the ball inbounds. 2:49 remaining here in Normal at the crown jewel of the Tennessee Valley as the Tigers hold on to a 62-46 lead. Welcome back to the campus of Alabama A&M University. Ranger swings the ball over to Farouk. Farouk's had a tough time getting the ball into the forecourt as he's met with a trap. Now over to Granger, back to Farouk, able to relieve him. Tucker's able to steal it away. Tucker pushing the floor. Over the break, he's going to be fouled. He'll be at the line for two. But what a defensive effort he has put on today, Coach.
Right, he's done an outstanding job. You know, he missed being on the floor. He's showing it through his efforts. He's played 20 minutes, and he's really gotten after it. A lot of times, the things that he's done on the floor, you're not going to see it on the stat sheet. You know, his energy and forcing turnovers and causing turnovers, a lot of times you just don't see it. You have to be in the building to see what he's doing.
First free throw is good by Tucker. We can look ahead now to Monday's matchup versus Prairie View A&M at 5:30 p.m. for men's tip-off. We'll be expecting, 7:30 tip-off. As right now, Prairie View and A&M sitting comfortably in the standings. However, that won't be too long as Texas Southern will be looking to move up. Ball was loose for a second.
Yeah,
as the foul was charged on the floor.
He fell on that. That kid slipped that time. But, yeah, you got Prairie View coming in, who was one of the teams in the preseason, was picked in the top three. And they're in Montgomery tonight against Alabama State. So you got a team that has won the championship 3 years. So you got a veteran coach over there in Coach Smith. He does a good job. But defensively, his team is a lot better than what we're seeing in Texas Southern now. So that has me concerned.
Indeed, as it felt like at one point, Texas Southern had a tough break themselves last season. And then they turned around and won the SWAC again, Coach.
Yep.
Tucker's layup falls in and out. Peek's able to recover it. Layup is no good. However, he'll be at the line for two. For Texas Southern, Coach, you want to be careful. We've seen plenty of times during the NCAA tournament, those 10-point leads will string out over time due to fouling, and then you look up and you're back into a ball game.
Right, and see, but the thing with us tonight, we just couldn't string together enough stops. Once we got the momentum, we came within three. We were within 3 points, and then they got an 8-0 run, and we never recovered from that.
Checking into the ball game is number 23, Shakir O'Neal, for head coach Johnny Jones. You may know the young man by the last name from Los Angeles, California, Union Grove High School as well, as he is the son of, what name should we don, coach? The big Aristotle, Shakir O'Neal.
Right. And, you know, his daughter went to Texas, is also a freshman at Texas Southern, if I'm not mistaken.
That's right. Farouk over to Walker. Layup is no good. Recovered by the Bulldogs. Hicks pushing the break. He'll try a floater. That one is good.
But see, what you got to do now, you got to build some momentum if you're Alabama A&M for that game on Monday.
Layup is good by Farouk. Lee tries an alley-oop. That one is broken up.
And I think Texas Southern is probably going to be I thought they were going to try to work some clock. But they're still trying to score on them.
Still hungry as the Bulldogs will throw in a couple substitutions, checking into the ball game for the Bulldogs is Messiah Thompson as well as Mari Peak. Peak rolls the ball up the floor. Layup is good by Thompson. Farouk pushing the pace. Met with the trap. He'll make the easy pass over to Granger. Granger to O'Neal. O'Neal to Farouk. What a behind-the-back pass. Offensive foul.
Yep.
Peak. Ain't them basketball.
Yep. Peak stood in there and took that one.
Peak sat in there and took the contact for the offensive foul.
Right.
Peak. Nifty handle. Off the glass and in. 1 minute remaining. The Bulldogs trail by just 11 now. Ball nearly stolen as Granger throws the ball over ahead to O'Neal. He'll lob it up to Walker for the layup.
Right, they got us on the backside because we put all our pressure up front.
Hicks dancing, hesitates, off the glass, no good. Walker unable to corral the rebound, out of bounds, A&M basketball. Just 41 and a half seconds remaining in the ball game. Hicks over to Texas Southern defenders, gets the layup to go. Barnes pushing the break now. Barnes loses the ball. Barnes trying to recover. No, into the hands of Thompson. Thompson to Smith, takes off for the wide open slam. Right. Ball is loose again, nearly recovered as Thompson almost came up with another steal.
Right.
Pass over to Walker as he'll hold it, as Smith will foul him with 15 seconds remaining in the ball game, Coach, as the effort by the Bulldogs is certainly on display here within the winding minutes.
Right, they're not giving up. You know, they're playing hard, but there was too big of a hill to climb this time.
At the line is Walker.
And this is probably our worst shooting game in this building. I don't know of another game where we've shot this poorly in this building.
That's the second of the two is good. The Bulldogs will go on to lose their 18th consecutive game against Texas Southern University. Last win coming in 2014. 2013-14 season as they defeated Texas Southern 63-62 on February 1st.
Right, and then, you know, one of the glaring things that we talked about coming into this game was rebounding. They beat us on the glass 40-28. And then they came up with 11 offensive rebounds. So as you can see, it's tough when you give up that many rebounds. You got to be able to rebound the basketball so that you can get additional shots.
As that will do it at the horn, Bulldogs fall 70-59. We'll look forward to hearing from none other than head coach Otis Dooley on the tough loss as both teams come together, Coach. This has been something that Coach Hughley and staff have established during the finale of every game. Whether win or lose or draw, Coach, they always come together, for prayer, for safety, and most importantly, Coach, for SWAC unity, for unity in general.
Right. It's good fellowship to see both teams come together. You know, the student athletes, they're doing it on their own. That's a wonderful thing. And you see Coach Jones with former AD Hicks over there. So it's been a great time. And that's one of the things that I knew that Coach Hughley would bring here, because he does a great job on the spiritual side for these kids, and that they need that, especially in today's society.
That will do. We'll take it quickly over to break here as the Bulldogs fall 70-59. Good afternoon and welcome back to the crown jewel of the Tennessee Valley as the Bulldogs take a tough loss here in Normal 70-59. Chauncey Sanders alongside none other than legendary head coach Van Petaway. Joining us now is head coach Otis Hughley. Coach, tough loss today. We knew it was going to be tough with guys being missing in and out of the rotation during the last couple games. It was good to see Cam back, but you guys fought hard, finished hard, but just a tough loss. What were your thoughts earlier on in this ball game today?
Well, we just looked out of sync, and we started out flat. And it was a big matchup problem with the two bigs, and I thought we would need to match their size, but we just couldn't keep up with those guys. And then we caught up. It was 4-4, and then we made some changes. Guys just pulled away. We lost people in transition. I didn't think we'd battle tough enough like we need to match their toughness and the SWAC intensity. And that's just been something that's going to have to change. 50-50 balls, rebounds, you know, loose balls. No, we got to want those kind of balls just like they do. And I think our guys are good kids. They're just nice. and things get tougher. And we just have to play that way. I think they got it in them. I just don't know what it's going to take at this point to try to get that part out of it. But it was a good basketball game. Our guys never quit. Our guys fought to the end. And we'll just keep fighting until we get there.
Right. Now, Coach, we had some I know in the second half we had two big long scoring droughts. We came within 41-38, and then they went on an 8-0 run, and then they put together another 6-0 run. What are we going to do to help us score the basketball more?
Well, we need more man-moving ball movement. And when Cam went out of the lineup for those three games or two games, it hurt that guy who brings that to us. Because Messiah's a put his head down, go get you guy. We need a guy that calms us down, gets us into our offense, put people where they belong. And we missed that for two games. And had we had that Jackson State and Alabama State, those would have been different stories. It's his first time back against the defending conference tournament champions. And you know, it's just, you can't take this time off in this rhythm, in this stride toward postseason. You need every game to help you build together, that you, especially a first-year team. And we didn't have that.
Guys didn't have that indeed, Coach. You guys also, despite the tough loss and despite the offensive struggles, you guys defensively were able to hold this team to less than 30% shooting from the three-point line. And also you were able to hold one of their top scorers in Walker III to less than 20 points above his average.
Yeah, well, early on, those droughts is because we settled for jump shots that we didn't make, that we typically make at home. And we didn't make them. And when those shots are going in, it's different. When they're not going in, it's different. It's like this.
Right.
So we decided, you know what, let's try to attack the basket. We started the half with a 5-0 run.
Yeah, that's right.
And we attacked the basket, and then we stopped getting paint touches, and that result, that's what happened. Those guys turned their defense up, their intensity up, they allowed us one shot, and we didn't offensive rebound, we didn't go after it. I think Blaze got tired again. You know, he's playing a little bit too many minutes. We need somebody to relieve him. And I'm just hoping I can get, you know, some more out of Shamar Biggs. And because Austin just came back,
right,
he was just really out of sorts. He hadn't played in five games. And that's two big holes, Cam and Austin. And it's fragile already. You take those two out of it, it makes it a little hard. But I like the fact that I got split.
Right. Now, Coach, on the positive side now, when you get ready to break this film down, I want you all to concentrate on what Cam did, because see, a lot of things don't show up in the box score. When you look at the energy, the deep, once again, when he stepped on the floor, the defensive intensity went up. So now that's a positive that we can take out of this game going into this big game on Monday, because you're going to be playing a team now that plays a lot better defense than this team that played tonight. Prairie View is coming in here after being down there in Montgomery. We're going to get them Monday night. What do you expect out of PV?
A team that's just as talented offensively, but has the intensity of an Alcorn. And that's where he came from. So he has the same culture. He bought his culture to Alcorn that he got from Prairie View. So, you know, we've been up against that. You know, we just got to get our guys back climbing. We had to lose ground. Now we got to get that ground back. Everybody else is still moving. You saw what happened to their point guard. Those guys, they were out. They were sort of out of sorts.
Right, yep.
It's no different. We can't be better than they are.
They're out of sorts.
We're going to be the same way. The one thing that I'm excited about is how we defended. But this is the least amount of points we've had all year.
Right.
Especially at home. Our offensive output wasn't very good. And I think we just had trouble with shooting over their length.
Coach, last question before we let you go. You guys have went on a four-game losing skid. It's been a tough one on the road for you guys, and now you come back against a very well-coached defending SWAC champion team in Texas Southern. What's your message now going into the locker room as you guys prepare for Prairie View on Monday?
Hey, roll them up.
Yeah.
Let's get back at it. Let's dig in. I mean, this is the time that you really, really graft out, hewn out all the jewels from a game like this and put it in your arsenal for going forward to get better. You know, I'm not, you can win all these games you want to. We just can't be playing this way when it comes as we approach conference time. We got to do what we can to make it.
Right.
And then once you make it, you got to be playing your best basketball. And if you make it, then you probably are.
Right.
Guys, last thoughts?
I'm looking forward to the game on Monday night because I know you and I know this team. We'll be back.
Appreciate it, guys. God bless.
That's head coach Otis Hewley joining us today as it was a tough one. The ladies were able to get it done in overtime. However, things were not turned towards that tide of way during the men's matchup. But we'll look forward to Monday night's matchup against the Panthers of Prairie View A&M University. For our dynamic cast behind the scenes, as well as Coach Otis Hewley and Coach Van Petaway and Chauncey Sanders here, I'd like to say thank you all for joining us and have a good night. We'll look forward to seeing you guys Monday versus Prairie View A&M. Have a good night. Go Bulldogs.